So we're just continuing our talk with Doug Tallamy at his lovely home here in Pennsylvania. And we're going to take a look at some of the wildlife. So here we go. So Doug, show us what you got. What is living over here?
Okay, this is one of our pawpaw patches. It actually started when we thought we couldn't germinate pawpaws, so we threw them in the compost heap, which used to be over here. Then they all germinated on their own. But what you're looking at here, that's a second instar zebra swallowtail. And this is the best demonstration that you really can bring nature home. There was no pawpaw here originally, and the closest population of these guys is about 26 miles away.
Really?
So we planted pawpaw on the property 9 years ago. This isn't 9 years old.
How old is this?
These probably came up 3 years ago.
Wow.
But it took the swallowtails 9 years to find it, but now we have a thriving population. And all the eating you see here, this is the end of the second generation of these guys this year, and we had them flying all over the place. And the first time they found it was last year. So we've created a population of zebra swallowtails that didn't used to exist, and they're you know, doing it all right here at home.
And this is with a single species of plant, which also is edible. Are you looking forward to trying it when it finally fruits?
These ones down in the holler have fruited. And yes, indeed, they're delicious.
It's fantastic. Delicious. Thanks, Doug. And here's a little information about pawpaw. The botanical name for common pawpaw is Acimina triloba. It's a small deciduous tree native to parts of the Northeast, Mid-Atlantic, South, Southeast, and Midwest. The tree is endangered in New Jersey and threatened in New York. The tree can be multi-trunked or single-trunked, is hardy in zones 4 to 8, found natively in floodplains and bottomlands with rich, moist soil. The tree appreciates full sun to light shade and fruits best in full sun. At maturity, you can expect common pawpaw to reach 10 to 40 feet in height by 6 to 15 feet in width. It has large tropical-looking leaves, which host the caterpillars of the zebra, swallowtail butterfly, and the pawpaw sphinx moth. In the spring, the pawpaw has otherworldly-looking maroon flowers, which are pollinated by insects, namely flies and beetles. Those flowers are followed by smallish tropical-looking fruits that get up to about 5 inches long. Those fruits will mature in September and October and are delicious both to us and to mammals such as squirrels, raccoons, and possums, and also to birds. The fruit has a banana custard-like flavor and makes for great ice cream and smoothies. Be careful when handling the fruit. A few people do get dermatitis from handling it. It's delicious and a great source of vitamin A and vitamin C. This is Kim Ironman from EcoBeneficial. Thanks for watching. For more useful gardening tips to improve our environment, please visit us at www.ecobeneficial.com.